I'm here at the World Health Organization in the middle of a negotiation on a pandemic agreement with, and I'd like to introduce Corey. And Corey, could you tell people who you are, who you work for, why you're in Geneva this this week, and how you think things are going?
Yep, I'm Rory O'Neill. I'm a health reporter at Politico, normally based in London, but I'm in Geneva this week. And I'm covering IMB9, so apparently the final round of talks for a pandemic accord at WHO. And in terms of how things are going, well, it doesn't seem like we're in the final round. I was saying to someone earlier, I've not covered a treaty negotiation like this before, so I don't have a great sort of reference point, but it doesn't seem like any part of this is what the final stage should look like. The disagreements still seem pretty fundamental. It seems to me like every time they come out of the meeting room for one of the breaks, the mood has gotten worse somehow. I don't know, maybe that's just my impression. But things seem pretty stuck, I guess. I mean, we're here now. They've U-turned on evening sessions, so people are having dinner before they go back in there, and like people are laughing and stuff. So I guess it's not that bad, but I mean, I've overheard a couple of very spirited arguments over the text, even at the table while people are having dinner. People are pretty exercised, I guess. And the pandemic is still really, like, it's a really serious, major, tragic thing that people lived through like a few years ago. Like it's not an abstract issue, and I think like, I don't know if it's normal for emotions to be this sort of raw and fresh during a treaty negotiation like this, but it seems that way to me. I don't know if that's helping or not, but it definitely seems to be setting the mood. I'm leaving tomorrow night, which is a shame. I think it'd be interesting to stay here next week in a bit, but I don't think this is the end of it. I expect to be back here next month. I think they'll go right up to the wire at the World Health Assembly. I'm making all these predictions on camera, which is a stupid thing to do. But yeah, there we go. We'll see how that pans out. So yeah, things seem pretty stuck to me, but you never know. I guess they always seem stuck before a breakthrough. It just doesn't feel like one's imminent at the moment.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how likely to get this done by May?
By May? I think they'll get something by May. I think they might not be able to deal with some of the stickiest stuff, but I think they'll get something. So let's call it a 6.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.